you're going to see here in this DVD is a wonderful story. It's all about how a studio started at these humble beginnings and with a small bunch of people, and they grew to begin becoming something great. It's how you're going to see the work that they put together, what they achieved over a 17, 18 year period, and exactly then go through and just hear some of the comments from the people who did it. Understand when you're watching it, this is a journey. That these people are exceptional people and they've done wonderful things.
Hey, I've got an idea. Why don't we tell them our story?
Oh, I like the sound of that.
A little backstage tour. Take them behind the scenes for a revealing and intimate look at the story within the story.
So, does this mean we're going back to the beginning?
Oh, no, Pumbaa. No. We're going way back to before the beginning.
Well, it was very difficult to begin with because in those early days we were used to sell animation. So I'll just show you here how things used to work here, mate. Look, I brought this with me today. Look at my collection. Now, in the old days, if you imagine that arm is on another cell, it's on a clear piece of acetate over the top. See, and what used to happen, you would hold this body for 3,000 feet, that would hold there like that, and then this guy's arm would move like that, you see what I mean? And he'd say, mate, you're taller, there you go, mate, see, like that, and you see that all right, mate, you see that?
To all those kids out there who are interested in a career in animation,
it's dead.
Don't do it. Stay in school, get a good education, and a real job.
There will be nothing for the bees to fly in, and that means no honey for me. So I must gather as much as possible. Oh, still not nearly enough.
This would be when I started back in September 1989. It was a rundown place. It was a sight to behold. There was no carpet on the top level. The rain flowed through here. People had desks hidden of wooden cardboards. People had to crawl under to get in there. The company had been bought from Hanna-Barbera. It had this mandate to do so well. Come in, make it work, or shut the thing down. But we were close. But we had a good team that got us through. Get up, I gotta get going. I'm gonna see a friend of mine. He's round and he's fuzzy. I love him because he's just Pooh Bear, Winnie the Pooh. We had here was we moved to this building in June 1990. It was the building that we managed to get all the paint back from overseas. From Taiwan used to do our hand painting, and we managed to bring the whole department back here. So through the time frame we were here, the staff numbers went from about 120 up to about 220. One of the key things when we moved into this building was people couldn't believe we're actually moving for such a wonderful building where we were to here. And the biggest thing that freaked people out when we had our big opening day was that it was a 10-year lease. And even then, the doubt about how well we'd go couldn't be stopped at that point, because people would come up and say, so 10-year lease, what does that mean? Like after a year, you can get out of it and get away free and there's not too much of a cost? But they didn't believe we'd be here.
And you said it was impossible.
The first one. Mate, I think it was a Gummy Bears episode. Here and there and everywhere. That was the toughest bloody couple of weeks. And at first I didn't know what I was going to be kept on, because I was really struggling, you know, with this full animation idea. But I just found it bloody tough, mate, you know, really tough.
Quads.
The day I started, I remember hearing all these people screaming and yelling in the background. Just people impersonating Goofy and Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck. I remember hearing Ian Harrowell impersonating Goofy, and they were just going off. And I'm thinking to myself, what did I get myself into here? Sometimes I feel like I don't have a partner. Sometimes I
a bet.
You must show respect to the simian family. Be good to a bullio, or you could wake up sleeping with the fishes.
Thank you very much.
The story, as I remember it, about the Return of Jafar was it was going to be a four TV shows. And then Tad Staines tells the story, he was the director, about Jeffrey Katzenberg and a guy called Rich Frank. They were walking past the edit suite and they just stuck their nose in and they saw the quality of the work. And at that time it was Marek Kohout's horse riding and some beautiful Steve Taylor animation of Abysmal. And they were looking at it going, who made this? And the editor said it was Australia. And they went, how much did it cost? They started doing numbers in their head. And from that, the director video was born.
Philistine.
Donald Duck saved Mr. Snoopy!
It's for you.
About those 500 cops. Seems the old bus blew a gasket, but... they'll be there in about an hour or so.
It's Aladdin!
Oh. Some of you don't believe.
What are you doing here?
One way or another, together is where we both belong. Ah! If we listen to each other,
we'll yeah! We'll never to Max is fall. On the tip-top! That Max, I know him!
For the first time ever, we'll see
you did that!
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, oh, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand, stand by me. So Pumbaa, Pumbaa, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me.
Whenever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me?
Talking to that dumb cluck, not you. So why don't you just drop and give me 37?
I am not dumb,
sir.
The last chapter of Disney here in Australia. This is the building where we really took that massive leap to do high quality work all the way through. That we became really our goal of being a world class studio, which we easily achieved, if not becoming the best 2D studio in the world.
Maybe this place was really sitting down and trying to create a place from scratch. You could just start and really work out what's going to make this place work, what are we going to grab, what do we need to make it a fantastic studio, and then add some of the special features that you required to make it that.
The great news is The Lion King 2 is now out on video, and if the first one was exciting, this is a great follow-up too. The beautiful thing about this particular one, the Lion King, The Lion King 2, Simba's Pride, is that it was done here in Australia. And Director of Animation Steve Trenberth is with us, and also Chief Character Animator Ian Harriwell is here too.
Steve, good to see you. Ian, welcome.
So the decision to make a sequel was an easy one, especially when the responsibility for the film fell squarely on the shoulders of Walt Disney's Sydney office.
Well, the new Lion King movie was released today in Australia, going straight to video this time. Hollywood had an awful lot of help from Australia on this particular production.
I never really met your tyrant. I mean, Scar. Scar, oh, heck of a guy. A little moody, but...
I play the part of Pumbaa, the lovable, heroic warthog.
We're on a, like, stink on a warthog.
Hey!
It's a hard truth, Pumbaa. Live with it.
And I play Timon.
Don't anybody move!
Sort of a classic cartoon character.
It's the crunchy ones that make the meal. Slimy! Crunchy! Slimy! Crunchy! Slimy! Crunchy! Less filling! Tastes good! Less filling! Tastes good! No fat! Check, please.
Yara!
Kovu!
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 Mother!
Nala!
Nuka!
Princess!
Scar!
Simba!
Simba!
Simba.
Little termite.
Timon. Pumba.
Nala.
Zira.
Mother.
Kiara.
Simba! Simba!
One question I've been asked a few times is, what do you think's been the most important film that we've ever done? And to me, it's a standout. Lion King 2 was clearly that film. It was a very special film for us to do, but we had to learn so much. The journey we had to transgress there was massive. We had, first time we were going to do digital, we had to learn the skills. People, we kept our same people. They had to be trained, learn new talents and new skills, and hit a higher level of productivity and quality than we've ever hit. For us to come through that, that meant people worked night and day. You know, you couldn't imagine how hard people strove to achieve that. And, you know, I can't say enough about the people through that period to achieve that and come up with a film, a product at the end that just looks so fantastic. You'd expect someone's been doing that for 10 years, not being their first project. So for us to make that, achieve it, and deliver such a great thing was really the foundation that built the studio for the next 10 years.
The 10-year anniversary party was good, and I think that was a highlight.
The 10-year party was quite good. It was a really memorable.
A good one in my memory is the one, the 10 years ceremony, that party. I still remember that. It's a very good one.
Yeah. Seeing Bosco in a suit and tie, it's, that's, you know, you carry that to the grave. You know.
Good day, mates. Michael Eisner, and it's an honor to personally congratulate you on the 10th anniversary of Walt Disney Animation Australia. Whether it's here in California, at theme parks around the world, or at an animation studio down under, it's the talent, enthusiasm, and spirit of people like you who turn dreams into realities. Like all members of our extended family, you are the key to the success of the Walt Disney Company. Starting with your award-winning work on The New Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, numerous other TV series, including landmark direct-to-video titles like The Return of Jafar and Aladdin and the King of Thieves, you've royally entertained children and families around the world for a decade. And now, with your amazing work on Simba's Pride, we are poised to make home video and animation history.
I got Michael Eisner basically sends out an email, you know, the big boss, and he sends out a group email, you know, saying, oh, how good Disney is and how good it went and all this. And I didn't know the guy, and I never heard of him, so I emailed back saying, I don't know who you are, but please do not send me any more emails. So, yeah.
Congratulations, and thank you again. Enjoy your evening of celebration. You've earned it.
I then said to someone, oh, who's Eisner? And he said, oh, that's the boss. That's the head of Disney.
Feel buzz like I had last week. I must stay deep, because talk is cheap. I like Angela, Pamela, Sandra.
Because that was my first one, and it was just fun cartoon sort of stuff.
It was a fun film for us to do. The props and the cars and the bikes, you know, there was a lot of fun interaction with the characters, with our riding, doing stunts, working with Goofy on the dance floor, doing the, you know, the whole timing sequence of the dance floor lights and stuff. It was just a fun show to do.
I have to say Goofy for me still, again, just the start of it, because I'd learnt, like, that was the time when I had no idea about animation, came in and just started learning things, like, about it. And still, I have no idea about it.
Do you ever wonder why we're always, like, wearing gloves?
There was a lot of creative freedom allowed to the animators, and a lot of fun to work on, too.
We were on top of our craft, so people then could choose whether they wanted to contribute even more. They didn't have to contribute right to their limit all the time. You could sort of go, well, I'll get through this one, and then I'm going to really give it heaps on this one. So it wasn't that feeling that every scene's extending it to the limit. And I know as creative people we like that, but it's nice to have the choice.
It had such a lovely sense of fun, and the characters were suited to animation, squashing and stretching
I think the most fun I've ever had with a movie over the last 8 years was Goofy Movie by far. It just seemed to, everyone was laughing.
Going somewhere, boys?
We're just looking for the little penguin room.
You're a mermaid?
Ariel, how nice of you to come. And you brought Flopper with you.
The name's Flounder.
Stop that howling.
I can't help it, Pop. Wild dogs howl at the moon.
There will be no wild dogs in this family.
Then maybe I don't want to be in this family.
Like it or not, you are a part of this family. And until you start acting like it, you can just get used to being out here every night.
Whenever she says hi, I didn't know that I could feel.
I never dreamed that.
Now to a children's classic being revived for a whole new audience, all thanks to a bunch of very creative Aussies.
Disney has a brand new movie out. It's a wonderful movie, I'm told. It is called Peter Pan in Disney's Return to Neverland. And the animation director from Disney is with us this morning. It's nice to welcome to the show, Ian Harrowell. Ian, welcome to the show.
Tell you that the dream you planned really can come true.
I'm her daughter, Jane!
Well, if you're Winnie's daughter, you're gonna love it here!
You get to draw all day, drawing cartoons all day, and getting paid for it. It's all come together so well. The colours, the sound, everything. It's just incredible.
I was starting out, and I was learning a lot, and really enjoying every day.
Oh, I get it. I'm dreaming. You're not real.
Just the improvement that everyone was experiencing. I mean, that was kind of really rewarding. Like, if you can sort of like I can look towards the end of that project and sort of see what I was doing then, it was just like a huge leap.
What I remember is September the 11th when we turned up for work. Yeah, this place was closed down. They told us we had the day off.
And for several days after that, like, there were jets doing low flybys. Passes around the buildings and everything around the city. So that was a pretty unforgettable moment.
Then hit it, Papa Bear.
Look for the bear necessities.
The original film was made, animated at least, by the original 9 old men who we all idolized.
Milt Carl, Frank Thomas, Ollie Johnson, for example. They set the standard.
Just fantastic craftsmen and animation.
About your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities of Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life.
No, hang on, fellas. I've got another one. How many men does it take to whoop a tiger?
Surprise me.
None. A little kid can do it all by himself.
That's always the highlight, is the characterization. But I don't think people realize, even if it's subconsciously, that it's the backgrounds that really make the emotional feel.
We've got a lot more of the village life in our film, which the original was purely based in the jungle. And we really only got a glimpse of the exterior of the village at the end of the first film.
That morning sun peeks over the mountains, and all the rhinos rub their eyes when they hear
what?
Hear the jungle rhythm.
We built up this model in 3D, the tiger's head, where we've animated it falling into the actual fiery pit. We'd get this base shape and then we'd actually incorporate it, so then we'd have it animate into the scene.
This is the best thing we've ever done, so
yeah, the studio is buzzing about it and we can't wait for the release.
I'm the associate producer.
Well, I'm the unit director.
I'm assistant director, working very closely with Ryan.
I'm part of the clean-up team and look after Timon and Timon's mum.
I'm character lead on Pumbaa and Simba and Nala and the hyenas as well.
Something tells me this ain't the travelling company of Riverdance.
I'm character lead for Timon, the meerkat.
Character lead for Timon, a shared character lead job actually on this one.
Production colour stylist, it's my responsibility to oversee colour continuity.
I'm the background supervisor.
This place has everything. Maybe it was just my love of adventure. Or my innate courage. My valiant and fearless way of... Okay, who's in charge of the freeze frames?
Sorry.
I just really enjoyed working on Timon as a character.
Way to sell it to the cheap seats.
Again, I've got a lot of respect for Ryan as a director. And, you know, he's very... He's a hard taskmaster, but I think it's one of the best things we did.
Thank you.
I mean, there's, you know, 35, 40 odd animators that I'm working with, and, you know, we've got to make sure that they're all animating the same character, you know, with the same characteristics, with the same mannerisms.
Nothing gets past you!
They're a fantastic group of people.
I learnt a lot about drawing, and I think it was just an enjoyable show to work on. And it was fun.
I'm liking three. Just, yeah, just the fact that we finished on time.
Do you mean one and a half?
One and a half.
Or three.
Well, it's called three.
But it's really one and a half.
All right, one and a half in the States and three in
Europe. Friends stick together to the end. I knew we had what it takes.
Because we're clever.
And brave.
And together we are gonna be great big heroes. What do you say, men? All for one.
We did a film called Three Musketeers. I was unit director on that. It was a great project. I think it was an easy project. I think everybody really liked working on it. So that for me was the best thing I worked on by a long shot.
Perfect bunch of people. This perfect character. I worked on the Pete character, Pete with Pete. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just fantastic to work with. So, yeah, it was great.
For me, it was like a dream come true just to work, you know, with characters like Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck.
It was the original show that we worked on, and we did, you know, we did it really well. So
that whole process of making that movie was pretty enjoyable.
Probably one of the first movies we did that wasn't a sequel as such. So yeah, it was good working with the original characters.
Why'd the music stop?
Look.
Dirk! Tarzan's alive!
That's impossible!
But I heard him! He was saying, don't tell anyone.
You've been soaking in the sun too long. Take two mangoes and call me in the morning.
It was just such a good little crew and group. That we just had a great time. It was hard work, but it was, I think back to the Goofy movie, and that was awesome doing that, and there's just been so many highlights for me. I mean.
Stitch 2 was a lot of fun because it was just all about drawing and layouts. It was really, the style was really pleasant to draw.
My first big opportunity as a director, big challenge, exciting. It was an entertaining project.
The characters are a great design, so it's fun to draw.
I've worked on the Stitch character and I've really loved that show. Had a good time. I mean, I've enjoyed a lot of projects for different reasons.
While the movie was being made, I was making a baby in my tummy at the same time, so the movie got to see Riley grow and ultimately be born before the movie finished.
You don't trust me. Fine!
you won't tell me what's going on, I won't tell you something. Ooh, what an interesting secret I have that I won't tell Jumba. Oh, my, it's a juicy one.
Quiet, you.
Okay, I don't have a secret, but don't shut me out. Let me in. Let me. What's that?
A sample of stitches. I don't mind spending every day.
When I was in backgrounds, they were moving over to digital paint, like actually painting with the tablet and stylus. So it was good to see them learn that, because some of them had never touched a computer before. So I got to like go through that learning experience with them as well.
I think visually it's just, it looked fantastic. It stood up on the big screen and they really could enjoy watching it. I was really proud to have worked on it when it was finished.
Well, I mean, there's more to it than just the film for us, because it was our first full film.
It was just a fairly well-rounded story, fairly well-crafted, and I really enjoyed working on the great prince there.
A prince maintains control at all times. Display dignity. Walk with pride.
I think we as a studio did a really good job mimicking the original.
Last year, one of the young guys here passed away from cancer, and I was just shocked and impressed with how much money we managed to raise amongst ourselves to help his family out. In 3 days, I think we pulled together $20,000.
Yeah.
And that was out of people's private donation. And that's something that I'll never forget.
Waking up in the light of a shiny new day, giving thanks to the moon.
Oh, hey, guys.
Boy, are we glad to see you, eh?
Yeah, yeah, because we finally found a couple of real moosets, eh?
Yeah.
Right down there by the stream.
Bye! Bye.
Toodaloo!
So long!
Those guys are weird.
Don't look, eh? You'll only encourage them.
It's like a family here, you know. I've known Ian since I was 21 years old. I've grown up with these people. Everybody I know works in animation, everyone. I met Leanne in animation. Everyone I know is in animation, so it really is like a family.
It's only after 5 years, like now, that I feel like I'm finally getting the hang of animation. So.
I've had a good chance to work closely with Bernie. I had a good chance to really do what I want to do.
Are you making notes?
Okay, this one here is approved. Okay,
can you just,
37.
Can you do
difficult, but fun.
Level 22.
Found over the years, I think just working with this team of people, as I've said before many a times, mate, and working with this marvellous talent and watching it develop, you know, from day one. They've come from all over the world.
Thanks to the people, thanks to the location, thanks to Australia, thanks to the lifestyle, people stay here longer.
You're surrounded by so many other people that have such amazing talent. It actually drives you and it influences you and improves your own work.
Yeah, people just get along, they enjoy doing what they're doing. You've got a couple of hundred talented people and jam them all in one place. There's got to be some pretty good stuff coming out of it.
Just coming to work, not feeling like you're coming to work. It's just, you know, hanging out with your mates.
I love the view, actually.
beautiful. Do you want to do better work? That's the main reason I enjoyed working with people I've got to work with.
With this studio, it's such an international environment. Like, I've met so many people from all over the world.
Disney is really the only sort of place that is a collective haven for like-minded creative people. I'd go gone insane if I didn't have fellow freaks that were into comics and toys and stories and all that kind of drawing and stuff like that. I definitely miss working in a cartoon-esque, silly kind of professional environment.
People with different backgrounds, people not only from Australia but from all around the world.
We really love the people, so the friends that we've made over the last 10 years.
Just the best group of people, made some awesome friends. It's a nice, relaxed sort of place, it's really good.
Being surrounded by such great talent, and it really inspires you to work, and it comes out in the way that you grow as a painter. So it's, I think that's been the most valuable thing.
It's fun, and all the people are so good. There are lots of funny people you can have a good time with.
Everyone's just so creative and fun to be with, and we're all creating films that people are going to enjoy.
We're also going to work, and people make funny things and have meetings above cubicles, and there's Thai.
Yeah.
For me, it's a family. I've known these guys for, you know, everybody for almost 14 years now. I grew up with them, you know, emotionally, mentally, and when it comes to animation as well.
Just an amazing experience, you know, getting exposure with all these people. So, yeah, it's just been brilliant.
And it's a fairly unique environment for an accountant to work in a creative environment where people are so passionate about their craft is pretty unique.
I totally hate working with these people. A good riddance to everybody.
People with so many different interests. Everything's just so varied. And I don't think you're going to be able to find such an eclectic people.
In the training group, we all came up together, that whole group. Those are good days. And just everyone else I've met along the way and worked with.
Who thinks it's funny to randomly put people's name down for massages when they actually haven't booked one, i.e. me?
Yeah, and the occasional email fired off to the new receptionist from me. Someone gets onto my computer and says, "Oh, hi, Charmaine, I'm the accountant. I think you're hot. You want to go out for dinner?" And now I'm deleting it from my sent item, so I don't know about it for 2 weeks, you know.
So it's not all boring in the admin world.
We touched football, and
we were legends at touch football.
Oh, that was really good.
A memorable moment at the Spring Swan. Didn't somebody smash a buggy into a tree?
When I crushed a buggy into a tree, which I think moved into the buggy.
Pretty much how I remember it was like this. Oh, jeez! Oh, my God! Boom. We're so going to get in trouble. That was how I remember it. The specifics of it are a little vaguer, but I just remember basically he drove into a tree.
Shouldn't bring up again because I've never paid the bill.
We haven't been able to find them. We've got a bill which we need to try to track them down.
We'll probably have to take it out of the redundancy.
A damage bill, we never really heard of it again.
It was a write-off though, wasn't it?
I think the buggy was, as a technical term for it, written off.
I don't know, what does it take to write off a golf cart?
It wasn't really my fault, although I was driving at the time, probably a little bit over the speed limit and a little bit over the blood alcohol level as well.
I mean, we weren't following all of the rules, but I wasn't even driving, I was an innocent bystander. Geordie crashed into a tree.
To be able to work in an IT industry that's surrounded by creative people is quite unique.
Fantastic! That's beautiful!
Nice. Turn your light up.
I never look so good.
Yeah, we have this clinking of cups, and that basically means it's a tea round. And we come to the tea room, and there's that thing, you know, do you have tea, do you have coffee? Sugar, without sugar.
And it has
the over 30s, you see, it tells. I'd come in, and I'd get my cup of tea, come back to my desk, and by that time Andreas has turned up, then Kevin's turned up, and of course you've got 4 rounds of tea. So, and there goes the morning. But it's not actually my fault.
I'm going to miss being able to go and get a beer at 5 o'clock out of the fridge.
To be honest with you, and table tennis and dollar beers. Yeah, stop the people. Dollar beers. Communication things.
Table tennis is the highlight of my day and the highlight of my existence at Disney.
That was a special time, the ping pong.
2000 doubles table tennis champion. Thank you.
If people would wind up and they do these things, but I'd always just come back
with time back.
It's break people's spirit.
It was the first time I went on holidays. I came back to see my head photoshopped onto the body of Richard Simmons.
And then it just became a tradition. As soon as someone went away for holidays, we'd get our Photoshop and edit something together. And then we had a bit of a thing where we used to eat wafer sticks, buy a whole bunch of wafer sticks and leave them in the middle of the table down there, and people just grab them when they want it. Yeah, so now there's a whole plethora of images down there. And nobody likes their own image, that's the whole point.
I actually really like going down to get stationery. There's nothing like getting free stationery.
First or second day just to get some supplies, and this massive man who just started talking to me and starting to have a chat, and I really could only understand the first probably one word out of every four or five. And
yeah, you got a hard work right there, tell me half of it.
And then he starts talking, I realized he was telling me about spiders. And he handed me this sheet of all the poisonous spiders that you could find in Sydney, and he just, what I got out of it was, don't let one of these little bastards nip you on the nuts, mate.
I said, Go was your favorite Disney character. Bosco was my favorite Disney character. So I went around to all the costume shops, bought up all the beards. There must have been 20 or 30 of us at least, dressed as Bosco. He had no idea. That was the big hard part, was trying not to let him know that everyone was going to be dressed as him at the Christmas party. He was quite pleased, quite chuffed about it. Once he figured out what was going on, he thought he'd just had too much to drink at first.
I'd just like to say, Dave, Costello, if I never see you again.
It'll be too soon, be too soon. I don't agree at all, Dave. If I see you, the sooner I see you, the better, really.
Rock on, kids. Don't turn your back on Scandinavian death metal. It's the future.
No, some are taking it pretty hard.
The time you can start, the 10 a.m. start's always basically one of my loves.
The work hours are good, because you can come in at 10 o'clock.
I don't ever get in here before 10, or like for a few minutes till 10. And
it's closing, you might as well tell the truth.
Well, it's 10 o'clock starts, 4 o'clock finishes.
Flexi hours.
Yeah, flexi.
You know, they took one of the toughest, they call full animation, they call it the hardest art form of all, you know, and it bloody is. No layman will ever understand what these guys put into making a film. They'll never understand the bloody work and the time and just the patience and the pain. You know, it just bloody hurts. Some of these poor buggers sit for 12 hours at a time out there. Every film that's come out of this place, mate, you can see the love in it and the work that's gone in it and the bloody perfection and skill. And the artistry and the technicians, every department have put their bloody guts into it. And it comes out on the screen, you can't fool people. They know, they see it, you can feel it when you watch these damn shows, and every one of them has been beautiful.
What's going on?
the gammas don't keep my dad out of our hair, his new girlfriend will.
Pretty cool canines there, Papa Dog.
Well, you are queen of the scene, my little Java bee.
Someday I'll fly away and leave all this behind.